Type 2 diabetes is a very common and serious disease that in many cases can lead to serious complications, including heart attacks and strokes, and reduced life expectancy. Conventionally, type 2 diabetes has been treated by the use of insulin and oral drugs. But unfortunately, up to 50% of patients who take medications, especially patients with associated obesity, are not able to achieve adequate control of their blood sugar levels. For many of those patients, metabolic surgery could be an excellent treatment option. And in fact, in many of them, if not most, surgery achieves adequate control of blood sugar levels, and in some cases, I would say many cases, even a complete disease remission. In 1999, I was a junior surgeon in training in New York. I knew a little bit about diabetes, but enough to know that it's a disease that is not supposed to go away. So I was surprised to see that patients who had bariatric surgery, within days from the operation, could see their symptoms, diabetes symptoms, completely resolved. I wondered whether there was something that made surgery so effective, and that something could be because surgery changes the anatomy of the stomach and intestine. And this organ, the gastrointestinal tract, is so important for glucose regulation, for sugar regulation. And so we set up some experiments that did investigate the hypothesis and found that, in fact, when you change the anatomy of the intestine, particularly the upper portion called the duodenum, but also the stomach and also other portions of the gastrointestinal tract, you immediately and powerfully change the way blood sugar levels are regulated. On the back of those findings, we became convinced that surgery could be used as a legitimate treatment for type 2 diabetes. Bariatric surgery was developed in the 1950s as a surgical approach to reduce the size of the stomach or to bypass a segment of intestine, and in doing so, reducing the absorption of nutrients and causing weight loss. We now know that this mechanical idea behind bariatric surgery is actually wrong. In fact, when you change the anatomy of the gut or reduce the size of the stomach, you're basically changing the physiology that regulates body weight. So patients reduce their weight not because they have a small stomach and they cannot eat, but because they simply feel less huge to eat, they feel more satiety, they feel less hungry. And also their metabolism is much more efficient, is made more efficient by the changes in gastrointestinal physiology. This is an excellent physiologic way to tackle obesity, severe obesity. It's not mechanical as we first thought. And so because of that, we now understand better the proper indications for bariatric surgery and the best type of procedures in individual patients. There is a number of procedures that can be offered for the treatment of severe obesity or type 2 diabetes. Those include gastric bypass, sleeve gastrectomy, biliopancreatic diversion, gastric bending, and also novel procedures that can be performed endoscopically. All these operations can be offered by a minimal invasive approach or laparoscopic approach, which reduces postoperative pain and allows an early recovery and return to daily activities. These procedures can now be performed with the same safety as many other common operations, such as gallbladder surgery or hysterectomy. The important thing is that we now know how these procedures work, and we know that each operation has a distinct mechanism of action. And therefore, it is important to decide the choice of the surgical procedure based on individual patient's needs. There is not one procedure that fits all, but there are different procedures with different mechanisms of action and different effects that might suit different type of patients. So our job is to identify the patient's characteristics, which would indicate one or another type of operation.